upon a time in America, our military was a
Welcome back to Let's Play Homefront. This is Nebros. Projecting massive power
anywhere in the world. And there's no
This is the King and everybody else.
And I'm just speak.
I am Peon Maniac.
And I am Duck King, resident badass.
Yeah, that's what you are.
Yes.
Welcome to loading screens, and you'll notice I actually remember to put subtitles in this time, and there's a reason I didn't bother with the rest of the time.
Yeah, I'm already getting annoyed by this voice of freedom.
This is interesting. Shut the fuck up for this, alright?
Look, if you guys want to listen to Three Dog, go play Fallout. He does better there.
I like how the one guy isn't in the frame for the San Francisco picture. What did he do?
So, welcome to the U.S. military. And enjoy the subtitles, seriously. If you guys can tell who's talking, you're better than I am.
I have no fucking clue.
It's Raptor 1, obviously.
There is actually one really well-delivered line in this area, and it's a guy over on the other side of the staging area, I guess you'd call it.
Is it really smart to park a large fuel tanker next to all your assets?
Yes.
Oh, always.
Shit. Especially without any kind of camo netting in front of the area you're attacking.
What's the worst possible thing that could ever happen with that?
Hey, seriously, look at these goddamn subtitles. You can't read any of this without pausing it.
Maybe you should...
What's
getting better at reading subtitles. Never mind, you know what? Yeah.
What time on the video are you guys, just to make sure I didn't debuffer or desync or anything?
It's about 2:03.
That's what I thought. Alright, I'm good.
So he's buffing the truck for some reason?
Buffing the truck, isn't that what you do in boot camp?
Yes, it is. Walk.
Just walk right through the blades.
That guy right there has got the best line in the game.
Which is, I hit this fucking bridge?
Yeah. He's the only person that delivers his lines with any kind of conviction.
Here's something really interesting about the Golden Gate Bridge. Once they finish painting it, they start painting it all over again.
Maybe you give me another time check?
It's about 2:39.
Alright.
Don't worry about it if you're desynced.
Nah, I just want to make sure it's as close as possible so I don't make too much of a jackass out of myself.
Well, they're really trying to channel a Vietnam thing,
yeah.
Here, aren't they?
I will say that this is actually one of the nicer looking parts of the game, even if this part's really silly after the rest of the helicopters show up. And I hate to say it, but this is the best mission in the game.
Yeah, I've actually played throughout this game on my own without any forethought into it or any... Oh, shit.
Those are Berkuts, aren't they?
That chopper looked like it took a lot of damage.
I don't know, modern Soviet aircraft.
I'm surprised I didn't fall apart at the seams anyway. It feels like they had the most effort put into this part of the game, and then the rest of it was just stapled on.
I've kind of said it before, but I'm pretty sure this is the mission that used the pitch the game, straight up.
Entire games like this, we swear. Oh, here comes the ridiculousness with the grenade launcher.
Make sure you listen to the audio, by the way.
Oh, that's nice. They used a grenade launcher and, pulled sound editing files from lighting firecrackers off.
Wow, was that a Wilhelm? I'm sold. Sold. I'm on board for this.
This mission, there's an achievement for this section called Wilhelm's Nightmare for knocking seven or nine guys off the railing.
Who in this day and age seriously uses a Wilhelm? Like, that was acceptable back in, you know, the Wild West days of PC first-person shooters.
You can get away with it as a joke, but it's such an overused joke. It's like Benny Hill music.
Yeah, like I would expect to see a Wilhelm in something like Bulletstorm.
Was that for? I was trying to count the Wilhelm screams, but I only heard that one.
There's a couple of other stock screams that you'll hear, and it really undercuts what they're going for with this mission when you've got a bunch of silly screams.
That was a very good choice to park that chopper right there. Right out in the open with that guy with the RPG. This is
It'll be
good
fine.
It'll be fine. What's the worst
It'll
that can
be
happen?
Fine. It'll buff out. Don't worry about it.
Well, it's nice to be,
look at this camo, by the way.
Leave a machine gun laying there.
Wow.
Now, in this game, do the camo guns that you pick up off the ground, are they any special, or are they just painted
better? They're orange,
better?
What do you think?
Well,
this has got a 200 round magazine and no recoil, so it seems pretty special.
That's all the guns in this game. I think they're slightly modified, like they're upgraded versions of the guns you can normally find.
Pop in.
This is ridiculous.
What the hell was that popped in? Was that a fuel tank?
I don't know. I didn't even see it.
What exactly was going through their minds when they made the guns for this game? Alright, so we're going with no recoil, and we want them all sound like metallic running conveyor
belts. It was a fuel tank, except they exploded.
What it is that they were Battlefield 2 modders, by the way. Keep this in mind.
So this game was made by modders? Oh.
The Desert Combat people.
This right here is the best gun in the game because it has 200 rounds, and I don't have to reload it 9 times out of 10 before I find something else to use.
So you're lazy is what you're saying.
That's a really odd looking sight on top of it.
It's one of those like 4 or 5 holo sights that I can't tell the difference between.
For a second, I thought the grenade launcher icon meant that your machine gun had a grenade launcher attached to it.
It looks like the HD-33 from BF4, actually. With tape on it, because you know we gotta make it look like it's been used in the war.
Okay, I do like this game's ragdolls with the grenades.
It's pretty satisfying.
Was that another Wilhelm scream?
Probably.
Why is there always urine stains on the mattresses?
Well, where do you piss?
Slave labor?
Because it's made by Battlefield 2 modders.
Where do I piss? I've downrange like you're supposed to, in a fucking plastic bottle or a bucket. You leave
your roommate to find on swing shift. Fuck it.
Personally, I find comfort in pissing on a mattress. It's not my mattress until I've promptly urinated on it.
So,
that's like a cat in my territory.
Once again, the Panzerfaust 3 is in use. I don't know why they're using German anti-tank instead of like the RPG 7.2 or something like that.
I gotta give them credit. It's different. It's not an RPG 7, so...
Yes, but...
the one time it would make sense.
Yeah. I was gonna say, you're trying to make a coherent world just randomly assigning weapons out to...
At this point in the game's development, I like to think they just threw their hands up and said, fuck it, this game's generic as hell, let's just throw this in there because why not?
So you're saying it's Spec Ops the line, then?
No, see, what they did was...
Boy,
Korea, right? They fucking imported all their weapons, and oh man.
Boy, that looks awful right there. Like, I'm not usually one to nitpick textures and... But that looks really bad.
He just fucking deleted
the kick?
Fence with a kick.
He sure showed the dust on that fucking fence.
He turned the fence into dust. Oh, what a kick.
So, once again, I struggle with ladders in this game. And I'm an asshole to Connor here. See, this is actually an impressive looking set piece, though.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's not bad, yeah. Other than all the buildings in the background have no windows whatsoever.
For this game, this is an impressive set piece.
Looks like I'm like I'm having combat wars outside of Disney.
Remember to lower your standards.
I will say this, and I was kind of saying this before, this game's soundtrack's a lot better than it deserves, and it's a shame that it wasn't used for a better game.
Now, remember to tally your railing kills. Games like this always have railing kills to make them look more impressive. They never just slump over.
Yeah, but we don't have a Calgon here to help out.
That's true.
I have a feeling all their guns were just modeled after like airsoft or something.
You know
recoil
what?
That they have.
I do like this little reference. It's cute. It's stupid, but it's cute because it's a Navy SEALs taking Alcatraz.
Oh yeah. I wonder if Nicolas Cage is over there.
Probably. It's green smoke.
It's green
too,
smoke
so, I mean,
too. Yeah.
So you know. That's not a bad reference. It's not in your face, it's not way over the top, and this is my favorite death in the entire Let's Play coming up.
Oh, yeah, you sure showed him.
Well, where the hell was that guy?
You didn't see him just hanging out back there?
I thought he killed that dude. Well, I would have got killed there too, so...
No, I died there because I've been recording Bad Company 2 footage too. And my Bad Company 2 knife button is the throw C4 button in this game.
I imagine that's the best soldier panic in the world. I fucking can't get my knife out of the holster here. I'm just gonna throw this fucking block of plastique right on his chest.
That'll show him, yeah!
So it's like Halo multiplayer with plasma grenades?
Oh my god.
Yeah, except those work. That did not.
Well, I didn't get a chance to pull out my detonator, that's why.
Just pull out that C4 detonator and just slap the shit out of it.
The military tactics here by these Koreans is fantastic. Alright guys, what we're going to do is we're going to rappel down the rope faster than he can shoot us. Eventually,
hey guys, we have
we'll
the high ground and we've got high ground and line of sight on him. Let's rappel down.
And that that reload animation on the MQ-49 is really sloppy.
I'm
half surprised when I hit them with my sword. That's their tactic.
These guys, it's like watching a comedy. I'm half surprised they're not dressed up in SWAT gear and going hut 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 hut.
Go go go!
I was actually really tempted to try and find my PlayStation 1 copy of Medal of Honor Underground just to show a better game off, but then I remembered that the AI in that game was better too.
You know,
like,
what?
Check that corner again just to see if he was still fucking hiding there.
This game is still better than Rogue Warrior. Let's be honest.
I don't think I've played that, but now I don't want to.
That's Dick Marchenko.
I played about an hour of that game, and then never played it again.
Suck my balls, suck my hairy balls.
It's a really good thing for you in this game that when you kill somebody, they drop their weapon, and also apparently 18 ammo boxes of ammo.
Yeah, this game would be a lot better if it wasn't so easy to just keep whatever guns you actually felt like keeping. I know that that's normally good in a shooter, but when you're trying to make this resistance thing...
Does that gun even work there? I can't tell if that's an actual gun, or if it's supposed to look like it's rusted and charred, or this game just sucks at graphics.
Yeah, get the hoorah!
It's a combination of all that.
Yeah. So, 5-1 says that nobody on that dev team knows what Fire for Effect actually is.
No.
I don't know what it is.
What a bunch of fucking assholes.
Fire for Effect is a smoke round you fire so you don't accidentally kill a friendly if you aimed wrong. Oh, actually, holy shit. They actually fired a smoke round, according to the audio there.
Don't you look stupid.
God, Neb. Why don't you trust these guys once in a while? I'm such an asshole.
Yeah, they made this game.
Yeah, how big could it be? How far off could they be? How did you even know that there was a guy there to throw a grenade at?
Because of the room.
Yeah, I was gonna say, this game doesn't really hide the fact that there's bad guys there.
That he has not been in. Obviously, there was someone in it.
Yeah, Connor was just like, hey, throw a grenade in there.
Oh, does he?
He says, toss a grenade in there, and you do it.
I was listening to Amon Amarth this entire episode, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, I would tune out Connor as well. Could you imagine...
The
like,
LT is killed in action. I don't know how much people know about the Air Force, but that's probably... they probably did a good thing. Lieutenants are fucking useless.
That was Army, but I think the sentiment's the same regardless of the branch.
Alright, so I'm here at OTS, what do I do? Just sit there and scrub the fucking toilet with this toothbrush and shut up.
I remember when they killed the McDLT, I was sad.
Could you imagine just running around in a battlefield just with headphones on and just tuning out Connor while you listen to whatever fucking music is going on?
That was quite the knife. The noise it made was interesting. It sounds like I see you're stabbing them, but it sounds like you're shooting them with a fucking nail gun.
Why can't I get a nail gun in this game?
It sounds like it. Are you listening to the audio for your bullets?
This sounds more like I'm shaking a can of change around, but...
Yeah, the audio's not that great. I'm really hard pressed to think of another game that had worse gun audio than this.
Why did the People's Republic of Korea decide to dress their soldiers up in what can only be described as snowsuits?
Guys in red and orange are supposed to be Special Forces Unit. The guys in blue and silver are supposed to be the... Elite Special Forces Unit or something like that?
They look like some kind of cyborg police officer from a PlayStation 1 game.
The guys in the with the red berets and the blue shirts are actually supposed to be police officers. Why are they flying in formation over... Never mind.
You didn't know that's what all pilots do?
I've never noticed that they were flight information until I actually bothered to look at this. Like, see, this is action. For this game, this is actually an interesting firefight, though.
Well, I mean, think about it, man. You invade a country, you need to display your might to the cowed populace, you do an air show. It seems obvious to me.
You should have posted an ad on Craigslist for this entire Let's Play and said, yes, I would like to find one South Korean to commentate, because this shit's ridiculous.
Well, as someone who has posted gay anonymous ads on Craigslist, I can tell you that this is very
accurate. Could do that too, I suppose. I don't know what effect that would have, but that works also.
My original intention for this was to crudely dub over all of the Korean with Chinese.
You should have.
That was far more effort than I was willing to put into it, though.
Why? You already put in enough effort to fix CQC's mouth breathing.
And
too bad you can't ride the tank into battle.
I was trying to.
Our tanks, we need to stop. We got a traffic jam. There's a fence in the way.
Were you there when I was riding on someone's tank in Battlefield? And then I think it was Chrono Jam. I jumped up onto his tank, and it actually fucked up the physics where it couldn't actually drive forward very fast.
I'm sure he appreciated that.
By the way, I don't think the Panzer III can penetrate on a glancing side armor hit like that, but...
A, no, and B, that wouldn't have happened had they just driven through the fucking fence like I mentioned earlier.
I also like how the tank just blew up and all the NPCs are looking at you.
I like how that military dude blew himself up, because why not?
I think there's a death coming here. I'll probably be editing this one out, so whatever you guys say here.
I think you should leave it in.
It was really hard to notice at first glance.
Actually, I don't know which one this is.
That pickup truck you shot fucking jiggled, and it's weird. They would have bullet reactions like that. You'd think they would just stay still, but they jiggle.
Now, you notice that episode 4, I think, had it too, where I was shooting... I have a really bad habit of good habit of dodging rockets in this game.
Not bullets, apparently.
No, yeah, can't dodge bullets.
That's the one I'm probably going to be editing out.
You know what's
but
funny
the,
is...
The
you
rocket
watch...
gave you a good sunburn.
Oh, look,
sunburn.
They do have RPGs in this game. They just decided to throw in other extraneous bullshit explosives just because. That's good.
You know, it's funny. You watch a mediocre shooter like this, and I think a lot of people feel maybe some sort of anger that they've been bamboozled into paying money for this subpar product. But all I feel is pity. I feel sorry for the devs. I had to work so many hours into this, and they know they're making a subpar game. They know it's not fun, but they still have to soldier on and get it done.
I was wondering that. I'm like, I wonder how far in it done, and I'm like, God, this fucking sucks, and I don't want to do this anymore. It's a paying job. I got to keep doing it.
You really should go read Roman Jenkins, or Lazy Fire, whatever the hell name he's on the forum. I threw it in the opening post. Where it talks about the development process of this game from start to finish.
Good thing those tires were there. Fucking.
Hey man, those tires.
I don't know.
Those
tires are. As someone who knows nothing about the development process of this game, this seems like a good idea. It seems like something very entertaining could have been done. And it seems like the elements are there for this to be entertaining, but either they didn't have the budget, or they had too many cooks in the kitchen, middle management type, saying, no, it has to be more like Call of Duty, but we're only going to give you this budget to do it.
The real problem is that none of their teams talk to each other, so the gun guys weren't talking to the gameplay guys, who weren't talking to the vehicle guys, who weren't talking to the storyline guys.
Yeah, right. And so then you just got this mess that sort of works, but then at the end of the day, it was a terrible mistake, and you regret making this decision.
Combine that with the fact that they changed the villains from the Chinese to the North Koreans, so they didn't screw their market over.
Right.
And rather than rewriting the game from scratch, they decided to get one CIA analyst who pretty much, because, you know, if all of these things that are less likely to happen than a lightning striking you 6 times in a row happens, then it's totally possible. Totally plausible, guys.
I think this call is degradating slowly.
It is. We're all turning into robots.
Yep. Actually, no, just Mattis.
What the hell just exploded in your face?
I don't know.
I like how this, I want to call it a BMP, but I know I'm wrong. It's just taking out everything else.
That's a LAV 25, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks like it.
It looks like an LAV then. Yeah. Yeah, it is an LAV. I remember playing in the multiplayer. You want to call out of the LAV here.
Oh, I thought I died there again. I was like, shit, I don't even remember that.
Cutscene! Explosion death.
And I love how this game calls attention to the fact that you keep getting, you know, you should be dead.
I like how you didn't notice the attack chopper just shooting at you for a good half minute or so.
I like that the attack helo is bothering to spend the effort to kill you, the one guy under the bridge. Never mind that there's armor crossing to assault their position.
Well, you see, I was putting holes in his windshield.
It's like, this motherfucker here put a bullet in my windshield.
Maybe we should take the time to shoot that Arnold Schwarzenegger like individual that's just mowing through all of our men. No, it's fine.
You know, to be fair, considering you're the only competent member of this entire assault force, maybe killing you is the right idea for that attack helicopter.
What is it even doing? It's just flying around. There's no effort. No effort on that pilot's part.
Also, again, the sentry turrets are 20mm cannons. You can tank a good, 30 shots from it.
Well, he's the average Call of Duty pilot. Just fly around, look for you, we can't find you, and he's gonna keep flying around until he finds you again.
Suicide. I literally ran through three of them at one point.
I wonder, in this point, if you just, instead of shooting them, started stabbing them slowly to death, if they would ever notice you.
I considered it, and I honestly didn't want to play this mission anymore, so I didn't.
You know, video games have taught me that North Koreans are only capable of looking north.
Because it would be weird if they actually did code that. You know, you could sneak in there and just start stabbing dudes to death.
It's a good thing there's just a javelin hanging out there. I don't know for sure. Can javelins even actually target?
Yeah.
Those.
I'm pretty sure it can. I just don't. Well, actually, I don't remember anymore.
Was that your C4 detonator that you just pulled out after that?
Yes.
You know, I remember when White House Down came out. I had to listen to a lot of morons talk about how completely feasible it would be for the North Koreans to invade the United States and take it over.
Wait, really?
Yes, I know a lot of stupid people.
That's being a stupid.
I thought you were gonna die.
Nah, it's actually surprisingly hard to die in this game unless you do something stupid or if the game decides you're gonna die. Usually you can tank quite a few bullets and you regen fast enough that it's not an issue. It's a good thing those grenades don't have any real shrapnel in them, they're just damage radiuses, by the way.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
They're just very violent flashbangs. I was trying to think of what other game did, health and shit differently. In this game, you take physical damage, you know, you see your screen shaking shit. I think it was Duke Nukem Forever, the more you get shot up, the more your ego disappears, and then, once your ego's gone, the next shot, you actually get shot.
That's Duke Nukem. I like how Fear did it, where you had body armor and then health.
Right. In this game, you kind of just eat a bullet and keep on going.
Actually, in a game like this where you're supposed to be playing, you know, the underdog, Stalker would have been where I would have looked for my health style.
Right. Where it does take your armor and health apart when you get shot.
And, you know, bleeding and things like that, because we're supposed to be playing the underdog.
Man. When I first played Stalker, the bleeding was so brutal. I was like, what the hell do I do? And then fucking bleed to death.
That was a bug. There's a bug where you couldn't stop the bleeding if you quick saved.
Oh shit. You're just walking around the zone just fucking trailing blood everywhere.
The best bug in that game was get out of your stalker.
Yes, it was.
Get out of your what?
Wait.
You would enter...
Sorry, Rihanna just showed confusion about IFF signatures after she doesn't bat an eye at anything else that you say.
Does anybody on your squad here actually kill anyone?
Obviously not.
No.
I've been sitting here in silence watching this for quite some time and I've seen not a body drop.
Nope, they don't kill anybody.
Would you say the bodies have not hit the floor?
Like that guy.
Oh, he died.
He just fell over.
So the meat shields. You've hired meat shields. The Colorado meat shields. Got it.
Like, the only game I've seen your AI partners actually shoot people in, I think, was Medal of Honor Warfighter.
Bad Company 2, Bad Company Squad will actually kill a lot of things for you.
Right, and also Bad Company.
Halo 2, on Legendary, you can actually let the ODST guys finish missions for you, so there's that.
Like, very few games have the AI actually do shit for you, because it's part of their... don't take control away from the players, it ruins their experience, quote-unquote. So, what that does for me, though, is ruin the experience when nobody's helping me and I gotta do all this shit by myself.
Oh, this is good.
Oh, the UCAV, this is my jam right here.
I'm liking how this thing's flying in circles, and I guess shooting rockets out of its side, even though they're all pointing forward, and this thing's flying in a circle.
And you can see where that wing is right there. I think that's a wing.
Well, guys, the Hellfire's laser guided. They can turn on a 90-degree angle, right?
Yeah. Also, you fired six of them about 10 minutes ago. Now you should have ran out, and this thing should have been gone by now, but you know.
Is that the Reaper 16 total?
Yeah, I think you've fired, 30 by now?
Probably. I was just gonna spam the button by the end there.
Why? You've just killed everybody.
Yeah, those six missiles really did open up on everybody in there. Oh shit, that guy was on fire.
Also, you know, it is really accurate that, hey, there's just a drone inside. I think I'll just take this small laptop and control it from there.
Jesus Christ! Why do they just not use Humvees for everything?
Because this is the magic Humvee. You only have one.
To be fair, the Humvees killed me in this game more than any other vehicle. In the single player. In multiplayer, I don't remember them at all, so...
I'm liking how...
They have nowhere to run.
So, I'm liking how you immediately tear through armored jeeps like they're nothing, but the second this RC car looking thing is around, it's like, oh, no, death machine, that's impenetrable.
You died.
Yeah, I don't know why I was hitting the countermeasure button and shooting it, and you're not supposed to be able to die as long as you're doing those two things. If you saw an earlier episode, the Goliath, our version of that thing, tanks a tank show, so...
Yeah, I remember you had your own Goliath.
Yeah, it was the best character in the game, because it never said anything. Why is he telling me a controlled burst? It's not like accuracy is a thing in this game. Actually, it might be. I don't know.
I feel like these Humvees are just full of gasoline. And that's the only reason they're just exploding, is that you ignite those fumes and they just light up like that.
We're lighting up the kimchi fumes, let's get it straight.
I don't remember, or I don't know if you guys remember this, because this was a long time ago, but there used to be this RC car that had six wheels on it that would, if it hit something, it would flip over and it would just keep driving. Exactly like that, and they just strapped a gun to it.
I vaguely remember that, yeah.
And so do I.
I remember an RC car that had tiger claws that popped out of the tires when it would drive.
Oh, shit.
Can you imagine if the U.S. military had that in this game? And then all the North Koreans would be like, oh, he has most honorable paw.
God, you're getting your racism mixed up there.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's made by this team.
I'm liking how the tires are impervious to bullets. That's also interesting.
Did that Goliath just fucking roar at you with its engine?
That is a pig! That is a pig sound effect.
There's a reason I said that it was voiced by the T-Rex in the opening post.
This is Connor Morgan. Enemy armor column.
I'm rolling in from the south. So, this is my favorite part in the game because Connor dies, but it's also the dumbest part in the game because there's no reason for Connor to die.
Oh, fuck it.
Drop the biggest fucking bomb you've got. Oh, none of those have bombs on them.
Why are they flying in formation?
None of them had bombs either.
Cause they gotta do.
They got a Moab on there, boy.
And there's no impact crater.
So, the thing is if Connor had just thrown the flare and said north of this position or east or whatever, you know, he would have gotten the
he
same effect.
He would have taken care of that, but it's Connor.
It's almost like they, you know, members of the team might have carried smoke grenades or colored smoke specifically to maybe help designate targets. And since we're set in 2050, why aren't they just using laser designators anyway?
Because then it wouldn't have been a dramatic death. Obviously.
No. They just ran out of batteries. Obviously. You saw in the beginning, he was just fucking stripping out radio parts and shit.
Nowadays, most smoke grenades do use batteries.
Sorry, go ahead.
Nowadays, most smoke grenades do run on batteries.
Oh, and here's the,
Home is where the war... Yeah, home is where the suck is, apparently.
No,
this makes perfect sense. It's made by THQ.
So, John Milius, Evil Tim was talking about it, we've all talked about it. He didn't actually write any of this game, he's more of a consultant.
Okay, so let me stop for a second. The final boss was a fucking six-wheeled RV or RC car that tears ass around the Golden Gate Bridge, and you shoot it on an on-rail sequence for 30 seconds.
Yep.
All right. Welcome to Homefront.
I have the feeling that was not their intended finale for the game.
Considering this mission's got the most polish on it, I actually think it was.
There's no way. There had to have been some big finish where you fight Kim Jong-il in a hind with legs or something.
Yeah, there's no resolution to this game. There's just, alright, we took a bridge.
Congratulations, you blew up their armor column. End of game.
Yeah, you
Nothing
blew up
about
a
anything
car.
Else.
And
Nothing
then a guy,
else.
A guy ran out on the bridge holding a torch saying, "Drop a bomb on me, you motherfuckers!" And that's the end of it.
No one on the Korean side thought he might be like, shoot that guy when he pulled out that flare. Because, you know, so something's fishy going on when you pull out a flare.
You know how it should have ended is, since they're just stealing from other games anyway, you should have just pulled out a blue smoke grenade and thrown it and should have heard a badly distorted radio airstrike confirmed on the way, and just go straight up enemy territory or turn to Castle Wolfenstein.
The best ending for the end of this game would have been a fucking apology.
Here's your voucher for a free game. We're sorry.
They're showing us all these names so we know who to blame for this.
Yeah, that was kind of.
Like, at the end of the credits, like, it just comes up with a code. Like, here's a free game. We're sorry about having to deal with this.
I will say some of the art direction in this game wasn't bad. A lot of it was really muddied, and I don't know how much of that's to blame on the animators, how much of it's to blame on the map designers. The overall art direction, a lot of it's fairly solid. I'll give them that. But that's largely also where they've got a lot of really small details, like the checkpoint having common phrases in Korean to speak with your guard so that they don't shoot you.
Huh.
That's the nicest thing I'm going to say about this game, other than the soundtrack is really good and it that soundtrack deserved to be on a better game.
Not much of a soundtrack. Not that I remember.
Yeah, the soundtrack wasn't bad, it was actually pretty good.
It was really good
to a piece of shit.
And you won't hear it 90% of the time because the game's too loud.
Huh. That's interesting, they're crediting the individual instrument players.
Trombone?
I think I've never seen that.
Do they really have a trombone in this game? Because I don't remember.
I'm pretty sure it shows up in some of the songs, but again, you just won't hear it because of how this game's
audio
is mixed.
When you miss time a grenade throw, it goes...
additional performances by a bunch of people that won't ever work in their career again? I don't know.
Hey, Hera Kang's in a lot of big things these days.
Motion capture cast, thanks for canning 6 out actions. Jessica Peters, I sure hope you enjoyed having vacuum sealed jeans. French team, Italians, Germans, wow.
So what exactly made you pick this beloved game?
To Let's Play or why I bought it?
So, either, actually.
I bought it because at the time everybody I knew was saying that Battlefield 3 is kind of shitty and I wanted a new multiplayer shooter.
I don't know when or how I bought this. I don't want to know. I probably was doing something questionable at the time. Or Steam still, I don't know. Either way.
As for the Let's Play, I did this because I didn't see it in the archives or anything, and I wanted to share the pain of this game.
And surprisingly, I have to say, enough, this is... people are still playing the multiplayer.
Yep.
I stand by my point, though, that I don't think this is, like, the worst FPS I've ever seen. You know,
it's not the worst.
Excluding obvious things like extreme paint brawl and things like that. I mean, you can do a hell of a lot worse than this.
The problem is, it's not just that it's a generic shooter, it's that it's got boring mechanics, it's got a nonsensical plot that you can't follow because it literally jumps around in the timeline. It's got unlikable characters. It's got an unbelievable story idea.
But it has no soul, is the problem. Is that there's nothing to set this apart from just another generic shooter. Like, you can take a shooter that's not that much fun, but spin it with something interesting. Like, in my opinion, I think Spec Ops The Line isn't that much fun to play, but thematically, it's really interesting. So that elevates it above, you know, something like this, where it's just like, oh, yeah, you beat the bad guy, cool.
Yeah, and I'll be kind of going over this. I kind of want to put a video together of how I would try and tweak the game so that the narrative flows better. and it basically reads as we're actually the Resistance, we're trying to sabotage.
Wait, they license Boeing?
Holy crap.
And that's why they went under.
So, that was Homefront, and I'm sorry for everything.
Thank you for subjecting me to that and keeping me up well past my bedtime.